This review was prepared by Georgios Bekos and Simos Chari and published by TheoryHub. TheoryHub covers a wide range of theories and acts as a starting point for theory exploration in different research and teaching and learning contexts. This is a review of the Upper Echelons Theory. The Upper Echelons Theory postulates that the idiosyncratic characteristics of a firm's top-level managers play a key role in explaining and/or predicting strategic decisions and organizational performance. Top-level managers' cognitive base and values exert influence on how they interpret strategic situations, shaping their decisions and resulting in market and financial performance outcomes. The Upper Echelons Theory was first put forward by Hambrick and Mason in an attempt to provide a new perspective on the two prevailing questions of organizational theory, which are why organizations act as they do, and why organizations perform the way they do. Before Upper Echelons Theory was introduced, organizational strategies and their performance outcomes were mostly viewed through deterministic theoretical lenses, such as population ecology and institutional theory. According to this line of thought, managers have little bearing on organizational outcomes because organizations are exceedingly inertial and are constrained by their external environment. Furthermore, strategic management theorists tended to attribute strategic choices and organizational performance to techno-economic factors such as competition-related and industry-specific contingencies, while the strategy process research centered on explaining the different routines of strategic decision-making without accounting for the influences of the people who are actually involved in the process. Essentially, the field of management was shrouded by the assumption that organizations can make optimal, economically rational and objective decisions by analyzing the situations they are faced with. Upper Echelons Theory addresses this theoretical gap by building upon the premises of the Carnegie School of Thought and bounded rationality theory. The theory suggests that strategic situations contain highly complex and ambiguous information, so making perfectly rational decisions is not feasible. Although organizations may strive to be rational and base their choices on a thorough analysis of internal and external conditions, the bounded rationality theory acknowledges that decision-makers have inherent cognitive limitations, such as limitations in knowledge and computational capacity, that restrict their ability to achieve technical rationality in their decisions. Under this view, strategic situations are merely interpretable rather than objectively knowable. Strategic choices are the product of behavioral factors rather than a mechanical quest for economic optimization. Managers fall back on previous experiences, take mental shortcuts and place their own personal interpretations on strategic issues and alternatives, and, therefore, a firm's strategic decisions largely depend on how its decision-makers perceive actual situations. Perceptions of strategic issues, however, are highly subjective as they emanate from decision-makers' personal biases, including their cognitive base and values. Against this backdrop, while also considering that senior executives are the most powerful actors in organizations, Upper Echelons Theory posits that strategic choices and resulting performance outcomes are significantly affected by the idiosyncrasies of a firm's top-level managers. Upper Echelons Theory can be diagrammatically portrayed as a conceptual model explaining the interrelationships among four key concepts, namely strategic situations, top managers' characteristics, strategic choices, and organizational performance. At the heart of Upper Echelons Theory lies the proposition that senior-level executives' cognitive base and values, reflected in observable characteristics such as age and education, affect how they interpret and respond to strategic situations through their choices, thereby influencing organizational performance. More specifically, the Upper Echelons perspective encapsulates three subordinate id. First, senior managers' cognitive base and values become reflected in strategic outcomes. Second, observable demographic characteristics are reliable indicators of executives' cognitive frames and, as a result, can be used to predict strategic outcomes. Third, studying the characteristics of a firm's upper echelons as a whole yields stronger predictions of strategic outcomes than focusing on the chief executive officer alone. The first tenet of upper echelons theory builds upon the premise that strategic situations encapsulate far more stimuli than decision-makers can comprehend. Therefore, upper echelons theory posits that managers try to interpret strategic issues and devise alternative courses of action by taking mental shortcuts and relying on their previous experiences. The second main tenet of the upper echelons theory is anchored in organizational demography. It suggests that managers' cognitive base and values are reflected in observable characteristics such as age, education, functional background, and other career experiences such as organizational tenure and aspirations. Admittedly, there are several difficulties in obtaining psychometric data on top executives' cognition, values, and perceptions. Unobservable, psychological constructs are not convenient to measure and, at times, are not even amenable to direct measurement. Considering also that an individual's cognition is shaped by their background characteristics and life experiences, demographic variables are thought to be valid and reliable indicators of the psychological processes that shape how managers interpret strategic situations and formulate appropriate strategic alternatives. In fact, a plethora of empirical studies has demonstrated that executives' demographic profiles are strong predictors of strategic choices and performance outcomes. Although this tenet does not account for the actual processes that drive executive behavior, it ensures the reproducibility of empirical findings and facilitates the genesis of an ongoing research program. Upper echelons theory emphasizes seven key demographic variables that can be used to predict strategic outcomes, which are age, functional background, career experiences, education, socioeconomic background, financial position, and the heterogeneity of these characteristics within a firm's top management team. Upper echelons theory further argues that executives with different career experiences, such as organizational tenure and industry or organizational experience, differ in their strategic choices due to their exposure to diverging perspectives and environments. According to the upper echelons perspective, socioeconomic background and financial position characteristics can also affect decision-makers' choices. Finally, upper echelons theory posits that top management team heterogeneity, or the amount of dispersion within a managerial group regarding members' characteristics, is highly pertinent to the study of strategic decision-making, as it represents the diversity of a team's cognitive base and values. Heterogeneous top management team encapsulate divergent perspectives, expertise, and knowledge bases, enhancing decision-making quality, especially when encountering ill-defined and novel situations. Diverse teams are willing to challenge each other's viewpoints and be more comprehensive when making strategic decisions. Diverse teams also show high levels of creativity and innovativeness. On the other hand, top management team heterogeneity can be associated with inferior decision-making. At high levels of diversity, conflict is more likely to occur, which in turn leads to a low group consensus on strategic choices. The third subordinate idea introduced by Hambrick and Mason posits that studying entire top management teams instead of individual chief executives yields stronger predictions of organizational outcomes. Since the seminal postulation of upper echelons theory, a substantial stream of research has focused on establishing the boundary conditions of upper echelons theory. Scholars have identified various moderators of the relationship between upper echelon characteristics and strategic outcomes, including managerial discretion, top management team structure, executive job demands, and managerial power. According to this stream of research, upper echelons theory has greater predictive strength in some contexts than in others. Upper echelons theory has been mainly criticized for a significant lack of attention to the underlying mechanisms through which top executives impact organizational outcomes, also known as the black box problem. The use of managers' demographic and background characteristics as proxy indicators of their cognitive base and values places more emphasis on broad tendencies, thereby neglecting the actual psychological processes that drive strategic choices and performance. Although observable managerial characteristics are convenient to use and facilitate the reproducibility of empirical findings, They encapsulate more noise than pure psychological measures and are often imprecise and unreliable indicators of psychological variables. Hence, ambiguous and inconsistent findings may be observed. Thank you for listening. To download the full review or to read other theory reviews, visit open.ncl.ac.uk.